I came down to the forest, there's less wind here. Can you imagine? All of this is in a city center. It's right around the corner from my house, and that's one of the many reasons I love Scotland. So if you haven't been there yet, definitely visit. Before revealing the sunscreen winner, I'm compelled to tell you about two SPFs that fell off my favorite list. First one is Prem, Protect Your Skin from the Sun. It was one of the runner-ups in my sunscreen videos of 2019. It's very sebum absorbing, it's very mattifying, and it works okay on top of the makeup, but it didn't pass the lockdown test. This year we've been working from home most of the year and I wasn't wearing that much makeup, and whenever I tried to put this one on, it would just suck the life out of my skin. I noticed another very big disadvantage. It's so hard to take it off, like literally I would have to scrub my face twice with like a proper brush, and it still wouldn't feel like it would come off. If you put it on the makeup, it doesn't kind of go into the skin as much as if you put it on your raw skin. I grew a lot of resentment towards it this year. I don't know if there's anything that can break this spell now. I don't think I'll finish it off. I'm not gonna buy another bottle. No idea what to do with this one. The second and the biggest disappointment in SPF world has been this sunscreen here. And it's so sad to see it not working, because it's been recommended by trusted vloggers. I've done a lot of research before buying it. Last time I mentioned it on my channel, I've been saying positive things. I said that it works well under makeup, because yes, it does. But when the summer came, when sun came, so did the freckles. The freckles are the first sign that the SPF just isn't working. No matter how much I would apply, reapply, wait before leaving the house, I would start seeing freckles pretty quickly, and it's much worse without makeup. This just shows me that this isn't working. Sunscreen is supposed to be this protective barrier between UV rays and your skin, and this just doesn't do the job. Maybe it's a fake one, I don't know, I don't think so. I'm not gonna buy it again. That's volcanic rocks. This video, I really have one core message. There is this one sunscreen that keeps passing the test, keeps doing what it promises to do, keeps delivering. There's really no fault in it. It's so hard to find something that fits your skin, that fits under makeup, that isn't too shiny, that isn't making your face white, that isn't too expensive. I am so happy to find one that works for 2 years now. This is this sunscreen here, Innisfree Daily Mild Sunscreen. It's a chemical sunscreen, new generation, highest efficiency. It gives the highest photo stable absorption of all available UVB filters available today. So this is really like a cutting edge technology into a sunscreen bottle. The deal breaker for a lot of sunscreen for me, especially the Western one, is that they keep irritating my eyes, and literally I have tears running down my face. Another great tip I found when it comes to especially reapplying the sunscreen during the day was to, I'll show you exactly, I just adopted a sponge from the powder like this. I washed it and everything, and then when I'm out and about, I would just apply it on a sponge, and it's so easy to put it in here on the nose, on the eyelids as well. We had this conversation with my friend whether we should apply the sunscreen on eyelids, but it makes sense that we do, you know, because it's the thinnest area. Basically, this is one of the most effective ways to reapply the sunscreen on top of your makeup when you're already out and about. I'm getting a little bit cold now, so I'm gonna start moving. Final note on sunscreens. Great dilemma, physical or chemical. Well, both have advantages and drawbacks. Physical are usually thicker, heavier, they leave the white cast, but are less controversial than chemical because they reflect the UV rays while sitting on top of the skin. Chemical ones get sunk in, which potentially can mean all the chemicals enter your system. If you ask my opinion, I am not scared of chemicals. Maybe scared is the wrong word, but I don't mind trying new things. obviously within limits. I wouldn't go for something that's known to be super harmful, but as long as it's working and it's practical, to me it doesn't really matter. It happens that chemical ones are much more practical under makeup and on everyday use, but for the body I really don't mind. Physical, chemical or mixed, it doesn't matter. However, with all that and me endorsing Asian products, the same thing that make them cutting edge and fantastic, which are the latest technology, newest ingredients, fastest development, can be not approved by health standards in some countries. For example, some of the sunscreens I showed you today have ingredients that aren't approved by the US but are perfectly fine in Europe. If that's you and you're worried about ingredients in Asian sunscreens, I would say either stick to those available on your market or do a research, and that should be sufficient for you to make a decision. The call is yours, whatever you're comfortable with. As I said, I don't really mind. I like trying new things, but not everyone is comfortable, or not everyone has health to be able to do so. So I appreciate that as well. Right, I'm getting cold and hungry, and I think we walked enough, so it's time to go home. I made it to the bike. This is my final stop. This is the city bike. It's like a rental Edinburgh bike. I discovered it during lockdown. I love it. Thanks very much for walking with me today. Have a great day. I'll see you in my other uploads. Bye bye.